This table is a table about the volcano in Iceland, and you are going to see here all the details involved with volcano, and will realize that this table is very, very far from being coincidence, as most of the things, almost everything, are minimal and also best meaning meetings. We know quite well that best meetings are very significant. So let us see first on the table, and then we are going to show how it was built up. So the table is the following. You can see here the words Ahr Gash, the volcano mountain, the mountain Ahr of volcano. Then you can see the place, which is Iceland, Kamirin, Iceland, all of them definitely in the same skip between letter to letter. Then you have the year when it took place. It was Betav Shin Ayin in 5770, or this is what we write today. I mean, the Hebrew date 570 in every two letters, which is a skip, minimum in the Torah. Then we have the words which connected with volcano, and this is magma. You know what is magma? This is the smoke, the material which come out from the volcano. And Efer, which is ashes. And we have here also the famous expression for this material of the volcano, which is Bazelet, Baslat, I think in English, Baslat, B-A-S-A-L-T, in Hebrew is Bazelet. Also, minimally in the Torah, you can see two letters. Here you have the word Alava, the lava which comes out. And here you have the expression of the Torah, Upatsa Adamait Pia, that the ground opened its mouth. This is in connection with Koach, that the ground opened its mouth and swallowed him, and indicating that here also the ground opened its mouth and the volcano came out. You can see here also parallel volcano, Iceland. Now, so we have the material involved with this mountain of the volcano, magma. Now, where it happened? Europa, you see Europa? The letters, every five letters, and the Efer in Hebrew, ashes, in Europe, really which happened. And this was a cloud which covered the sky. You have here the Hebrew words, Kisa Anan. So every Kisa Anan, a cloud covered by Efer, by ashes in Europe, and the material which was magma. Now we wanted to know more about what is really happening, what and why, and for this we use the words onesh, whether it was punishment. It came here, onesh, you can see, parallel to Iceland, parallel to volcano. And then we saw the word atra'ah, warning, parallel to onesh. And Edom, you know quite well that Edom is a name for the nations of Europe, the state, and Russia. So somehow it is a warning and punishment even to those nations. So the question why? So this we looked for as a rabbi, famous rabbi, great tzaddik in Israel, the Rebbe of Shomrei Emunim, said that the volcano was a punishment and warning on Edom, on Europe, the state. You can see also Obama comes here, who put a lot of pressure on Israel to give up the land, especially Jerusalem. So God, as we know quite well, when he is warning, earthquakes coming, tornado coming, and volcano coming. So amazingly, it fits with the idea. Then we have in this table also the word onesh, letter after letter, and Edom, the Edom, which really basically is the same idea. All came to make pachad, to bring fear on the nations. So let us see now the whole table, with the teaching in one way. So you have your Argash, the mountain of the volcano in Iceland, which happened Betav Shin Ein, which is 2010, but for us it's definitely in 770. And as a punishment, as a warning to Edom, and Obama can see also, because he is this one who puts his pressure, influence other nations to do it. And what is really happening, you see here, it is the magma, the ashes in Europe, which the cloud covered. So this is really the table, and in fact you can see yourself that things which are appearing are not coincidence, they are exactly parallel, the same distance between the letter, right? It is definitely not coincidence, especially the phenomena that you see here about words which are minimal, like Bazelet, Betavshinai. Here you have also the word aviation, Teufa, in Hebrew Teufa, aviation, which was affected by this cloud. And interesting that the continuation of this sentence is lo Teufa, no aviation. This was the cloud caused the aviation to stop. So, clear table, very coincidence, very far from being coincidence, and important teaching to us that there is a God. We are not the boss of the world. We cannot tell Israel what to do because there is a God, and Israel is a holy land, and one cannot put pressure on Israel to do things which is against the Torah, against the law.